And I wanted to share this with you, especially for the question that you asked, is that we realized that when we showed the video, most companies have a video of the manager, you have the video of the CEO, and most people on the base really don't meet those guys. So we scrapped that video altogether. And we actually put a video of the person who is there in the system, on the ground, base level, who's been in the system for a year. And we simply just did that much. And all that person did was talk about what he happened to him in the organization. And what really took place is that when that guy finished the training and he went on the floor, he said, "Bhai, he's the guy, aap hi tha video mein." And that immediately started creating a connect. Okay, and that's what kind of helped. The other thing that we wanted to share here is that we told the HR guy, let's not look at saving the guy for a whole year. Let's try to save him for three months. So we broke down his attrition to ensuring that if a normal, if you look at data, and the guys, after 6 months or 9 months, starts moving, can we actually push that for 3 more months? That is 12 months. Do another intervention to push it for another 3 months, and that is 18 months. Now, when you're doing these small bite-sized things that you can actually make those effective, you actually make the organization have a better ROI on that guy joining. All of us are familiar with this, exit analysis. We talk about hard education, relocation, all these are kind of some of the dashboards that happen in some organizations. So we said, maybe that's old school. So there was another organization that came to us and said, what is it that we need to do to understand why people leave? So I said, the first thing that we need to do is scrap this. And then we came up with something that is a little radical. We said that can we look at some models, and this is only one example I am putting up here for you. We all know Kano model. And it is a model that has been there to look at product development and customer satisfaction. Can that be tweaked? And can the questions that we ask a person who is leaving the organization revolve around what is it that we need to do to either know what is dissatisfying, to know what is it that is satisfying, and to know what that excites? And that is, and for this organization, that's exactly what we did. So we kind of removed the complete exit analysis to know better prospects and health reasons, because it gives you no real action. And then when we started asking questions to tell us what makes you satisfied, dissatisfied, and excites, you started getting actions. And we looked at only 5 things that the organization could do. And those 5 things had involvement of the CEO, had involvement of the manager, and the HR. This is some of the work that we've done. So, ShareYourHR is an organization that provides, and today we talked about the world is moving towards consulting. A lot of professionals are going to be consulting. So one of the backdrops, the back that we use is consulting CHRO. So as ShareYourHR, we are consulting CHROs to a lot of medium-sized organizations, helping them to put HR strategies and processes in place. We manage employee lifecycle, change management, and all the kind of stuff that we put up here is what we do, including employee wellness and governance. So employee lifecycle, we talked about, somebody said, how can a team of HR guys spend more time? You know, that was one of the questions. I think a lot of organizations today are looking at saying, can the lifecycle management be outsourced? So that the existing HR team can spend more time on stuff that is important, like creating employee experiences, doing a little more of listening, and taking that HR strategy that is there and actually seeing it, you know, happen in the organization. So one of the things we do is this. We have our own HR system that helps us do this. The last thing that I wanted to talk about here was the topic of talk called HR middleware. We talked about SAP. A lot of people asked about technology, and we said, how is it that you know, we need to adapt that? One of the things that we've done is we looked at, and as an HR professional, I realized that SAP, Vanco, Adrenaline, Zing, whatever software you are, PeopleSoft, is good, and they have good plus points and negative points. But as organizations move towards a workforce that no longer sits inside the organization, they are either at client locations, or they are at remote offices where there are 10, 15, 100 people who can't have an HR guy or, you know, for them. We came up with a middleware. And the middleware is nothing but an appless kind of world which allows an HR, which allows an experience to the employee and the HR guy. It sits on the HRMS, allows you to communicate with employees in an appless environment, allows a guy through his WhatsApp, to his Facebook Messenger, to apply for leave, to know about the organization, to allow you to push a newsletter to him from the CEO, to push the fact that he needs to do performance appraisals, etc. And the end of that, we also said that BI reporting is very important. For a lot of us, the HR dashboard is very critical. So that's how we ended that particular middleware with. This is our own in-house program whenever we are in an organization. This is the kind of steps we follow to ensure that whatever we are doing is actually driving the entire, the end result for what the organization is employing. Some of our dashboards. We also, I'll just take 2 more minutes. We also do a lot of employee wellness. So we've tied up with the LBG Systems of the United States, which is a set of programs that are not just is designed purely for corporates. Okay, and one of the programs I've listed here, and I think the fundamental difference in this program is that it talks about prevention rather than dealing with the stress in the workplace. So a lot of these programs is what we run inside of India. And finally, Karma and ShareYour HR have partnered with the Great Managers Institute, because we know that people join organizations but they leave their managers. And so we partnered with them to not only kind of do the work that we do, but also kind of build over a period of time great managers. Okay, so that's the kind of work we are doing with them. We also have the Forbes magazine along with the GMI Institute. And that helps us in kind of not only just taking HR practices, but also helping organizations develop great managers. Okay, so I finally leave you with this last line. We have expertise to kind of manage our HR lifecycle, and that's the whole shared service model. We are working with organizations even in the Middle East, so this is a company in the Middle East that has outsourced its entire HR to us, and we are managing it here from India. We have our own middleware to deal with the shared service, and finally, what we basically want to do is create that employee experience. So that's our contact details, and in the end, come and share your HR for you. We have all your business cards with us in that wonderful glass bowl that we kept outside. So what we're going to do is 10 lucky professionals, we will get a kind of complimentary HR compliance audit done from Karma and share your HR. And we'll ask Amne Saab at the end of the day today to pick those 10 people. Thank you very much. I hope I was within my 5 minutes. Thank you.
We'll be starting off with the second half of the session at sharp 4:40 p.m. Thank you.